Hello again, this is Calvin from PoorManSurvival.com, and today we're going to talk about the Sabercut chainsaw. A lot of you have seen the old school survival chainsaws, you know, the thin piece of wire, they all snap, they have a key ring on them, you cut your fingers open. This is supposed to be the next evolution of that. So I picked this one up to give it a try. It comes in this box here. Let's see what we have inside. So it comes in a small pouch with a belt loop. Pouch isn't the best quality, but it's not horrible. It definitely is usable, and I would recommend, after using this tool several times, storing it in the pouch, so that way you don't cut or tear anything that you have would have laying in there with it. And you should keep this tool oiled. So, pulling it out, it is very similar to a standard chainsaw blade. All right, so I'll try and get some of this up here so you can see how it's set up. All right, it does have these standard rippers. Sharpens very similar to, well, sharpens the same way as a chainsaw. It's have to be a little more delicate because the teeth are not that big. All right, and they are fairly wide spread apart. So we'll talk a little bit more about that in a minute. All right, and on either side, it does have these nylon handles and this, you know, bendable link. All right, and it works very similar, well, it works very similar to a chainsaw. So you just wrap that around what you want to cut. You grab your two handles and you pull to cut it. So my first impressions are, I took this out on a on a camping trip, and it works well, especially if you have someone to really hold what you're cutting. The downfall is, I think it needs more cutting teeth. They're too far spread out. It worked well for larger items and less for smaller branches. I'll try and get a video up very soon of me using this tool. You really have to dig in with it. And it's only because, you know, for every one cutting tooth, you have almost about two ride teeth. You know, that in a chainsaw, it's going to be every other. You're going to have a cutting tooth, and then, you know, then it's going to skip one, cutting tooth, skip one. This is skipping almost two and a half. To cut, and I think it needs more. I think the reason they did that is to save your strength, so that you're not pulling all those cutting teeth. But honestly, I think that's what this device needed, was more cutting teeth. Does it work? Yeah, I think it works pretty good. I think the larger item you're cutting, it's going to move less and it's going to work well. I didn't like it for cutting small branches, but when I cut probably a 3-inch piece, yeah, it went pretty well. The only thing I can tell you is keep these oiled. 3-in-1 oil, WD-40, something like that, is going to keep these oiled. If these start getting wet, all of you who own chainsaws know, you're going to dull them up. And you're not going to be able to use a standard knife sharpener with this. You're going to really need that chainsaw sharpening tool to really get these sharpened well. But does it, yeah, it folds up really small. I love the fact that it has these handles on it. Just pop one open so you can see the width. You know, you can really get in there and get a good grip. And I love that. I love the fact that this moves. Those little chain type ones, they say, oh, make a snare, cut down a tree, build a log cabin. Yeah, no, that's not going to happen. This tool works well. You just have to know its limitations. And when you're cutting small branches that are wiggling all over the place, this just does not have the teeth to stay bit in. But when you're cutting a larger, you know, branch, a larger limb off a tree or something like that, you know, it works very well. So as a bug out bag type tool or a backpacking type tool, it's not bad. Like I said, it folds up really small. It fits right back in the pouch. You don't have to fight with it much. I like that. Would I take this over my bow saw? Absolutely not. I use an external pack frame when I'm camping and long distance hiking, and I strap a bow saw to it. And I think that's the only way to fly when it comes to a saw. Is this a handy little tool for a bug out bag, you know, to leave in a car, to take, you know, camping, you know, on a hike where you might be getting some small amount of firewood, you know? Yeah, I think it is. It's a handy tool. Just not going to be, you know, it's not the chainsaw that some of the advertisements say they are. But it does work well. Definitely buy this over that cheap little piece of wire you're thinking is going to cut down a tree. It's not going to happen. This is going to do a much better job. And the quality's there. I haven't broken it. And I used it quite a bit the weekend I used it. So again, I can't complain. So look at these. You know, several retailers have them. Shop around for the best price. Some retailers, these are very expensive. And others, you can get pretty good prices. But this one, you know, this one is the UST Saber Cut. And I think it's a, you know, this is a decent brand for this. I've seen some generic ones. You know, be aware when you're looking at them that it's, you know, there are some knockoffs out there. So the Saber Cut is a pretty good one. This is the one I've tested, you know, the Ultimate Survival Gear Saber Cut. And I like it. But I've seen a couple of knockoffs. Honestly, I'm not going to lie. You can make one of these yourself. You take that a piece of chainsaw blade, you know, and make it yourself. I've seen it done before, and they work very well. You may just work a little harder to cut with them because the more blades biting into the log, the harder it's going to be for you to cut. It's going to take more body strength. So take a look at it. Check it out. Let us know what you think. You know, like the video if you liked it. Subscribe. We have a lot of videos coming out. Please, if you get a chance, take a moment and go to our Facebook page, poormansurvival.com, and we're going to be getting some outside videos coming up very shortly on the use of these items, and I have some surprises coming up with some big new items. So thank you again for watching. This has been Calvin for poormansurvival.com.